Hey everyone, it's Will, Gamer Dad, with another video for you. So first off, I'd like to give a shout out to one of my Patreon supporters, Ben. Thanks for your support. Now, I just woke up and I saw a lot of the new trailers and the official live stream from the Another Eden Global channel. Make sure if you haven't caught those, check it out. Make sure you subscribe as well. There is a Chronostones campaign where if you subscribe and you hit the milestones, you do get extra Chronostones. I believe we actually already get 600. Although there might be a stretch goal, in which case, hey, why not like and subscribe to the official AE channel? Now that being said, first of all, I was surprised to see a notice this morning, and it looks like first part is to feature Brilliant and Twin Destinies encounter. So for those who are relatively new to the game or about to join the game due to the newest crossover, aka Chronocross, welcome to my channel, welcome to Another Eden. These kind of banners are always limited. They are special event types, they don't always occur. So there are two types. One is called a Twin Destinies encounter, which is paid stone, so you need to spend 1,000 paid stones, which is real cash, unfortunately. However, it guarantees 2 5-stars, and keep in mind, this one features 2 either AS, another style, or ES, extra style units. And that is a lot of value compared to most paid banners, since most paid banners only guarantee 1 5-star. Not only that, AS and ES units are, in general, much harder for a free-to-play or a light spender to upgrade or side-grade, in which case you are getting value that way instead of having to pull the normal style version and then use a bunch of rare materials such as chant scripts and treatises or codexes to side-grade those. So very, very good banner. I guess when the banner officially drops, and it drops, it looks like December 6th, that should be Japan time, so I'm guessing it's probably tomorrow evening. I'll do a Should You Summon video on that. Now, that being said, for free-to-plays, you also do have the Brilliant Encounter, which is a one-time only, and this guarantees 4.5 or better. And so again, for those who are relatively new to the game, the game system has anywhere from 3-star to 5-star units. 3 stars are very common, have limited potential. 4 stars are moderate use, however, in endgame use, they are not used very often. However, 4.5s are a type that can be upgraded, just like those AS and ES units, to a 5-star unit. And so if you get a 4.5, eventually, a few months down the road, you can upgrade that to a 5-star, which is the most powerful class or most powerful form of that unit. This is one of the great ways that free-to-plays and other spenders can kind of grind out weaker units and make them a lot stronger if you have the upgradable 4-star class. So we call them 4.5s. And I believe if you haven't caught the live stream, make sure you catch it, because when the crossover with Chronocross drops, we should get 1,000 stones for free. Not only that, if you're brand new to the game and you download it, I believe you get an extra 1,000. So for new players, it should be 2,000. For us veterans, it should only be 1,000. But that being said, you can use the 1,000 right on the Brilliant Encounter if you so choose. Otherwise, there are plenty of cool banners that are available in the game currently, especially when the Chronocross collab or symphony drops. I am extremely excited about that drop. Let me know in the comments below if you've already watched the trailer, what your thoughts are, your feelings, and if you're going to be playing it. I'm assuming everyone here is going to be playing it. The music is very nostalgic. Now, for those who don't know, the reason I started this channel and also started Another Eden is because I actually was a player of Chronocross back in high school. By the time Chronocross dropped, I was actually already married and working as a full-time and didn't really have the chance to play it as. So I regret my decisions back then. However, I will be exposed to some of the main characters here, and so I'm sure anyone who's a veteran of Chronocross will probably educate me as I create content based on that symphony crossover. Now, back to the update here. And again, this is very unique that the update dropped kind of overnight. There is a Chronostone package if you decide to buy it. This is interesting. It's only a 2,000 stone package, so no 4,000 stone package. But I guess given the context of the drop, makes sense. 2,000 stones will buy you at least one of that Twin Destinies encounter. Anyways, again, if you have used the free trial for the Guide of the Heavens and Guide of the Land, remember that the trial period is coming to the end, and so if you don't want to spend additional money on the monthly pass, you will have to cancel it at least 2 days before. If you haven't started it yet, and I believe that anyone who's new to the game will get the chance to start the trial if they so choose, you can always activate it at another time. For myself, I actually have not activated that yet, and so it's just sitting there. I'm sure I can do that whenever I feel like doing so in the future. And again, as we all said, look at the crossover event Symphony Complex Dream with Chrono Cross. Very, very excited about that. Make sure you watch it, like I said, on the official channel. And keep in mind, again, if you're relatively new to the game, all content in Another Eden is permanent. So I'll repeat that. All content in Another Eden is permanent. If you don't get a chance to finish the Chrono Cross crossover in a certain amount of time, don't worry, it's always there. They also feature a lot of free units, and so the main characters from Chrono Cross should be free and permanent, and you'll get them, and they are going to probably be pretty powerful, so looking forward to that as well. Otherwise, time to get back to the game, get back to grinding, and probably sleeping a little bit more, because I think I'm going to be losing a lot of sleep in the next week or so, doing as much as I can on this crossover. I believe I will probably try to do a live stream when it drops, barring a lot of technical difficulties, and some of my previous live streams have had those, but hopefully you're patient if you decide to drop by on the live stream. Otherwise, have a great weekend, everyone, and we'll see you next time.